Hi everyone, myself Dr. Priyanka Sharma. I'm a consultant gynecologist at Fortis Hospital, Mohali. So let's talk something different today. Let's talk about the common problems that a woman faces after pregnancy or childbirth, especially after vaginal deliveries, and how we give an edge to the treatment of these issues with an aim to enhance your quality of life to give you your best. So commonly encountered problems include vaginal discharges, that includes vaginal dryness, painful intercourse, and SUI, stress urinary incontinence, that is also commonly called as urinary leakage, and last but not the least, recurrent urinary tract infections. So before discussing the symptoms of these problems and what kind of treatment we are providing you, let's understand what is the normal vaginal surface structure and why these problems are commonly encountered after pregnancy and after childbirth. So if we talk about normal vaginal surface, it is never a plain surface. It is not like a page. It is not a flat surface at all. It has number of folds, numerous folds. These are called rugosities or rugae. And these rugosities, they add resilience and elasticity to the vaginal tissue. So why these rugosities are important? So these folds are responsible for the vaginal health, for vaginal hygiene and your sexual health. And these are commonly affected with pregnancy because there is change in the hormonal milieu while pregnancy and while lactation. And during the childbirth, especially in the vaginal deliveries, there is overstretching of the vaginal tissue that causes the flattening of these rugae. And these flattening of rugae, they cause the vaginal laxity, that is loosening of the vagina. And this laxity give all these symptoms that make 50% of the females predisposed to vaginal discharges, and around 30% of the females, or I should say one in every three female, become predisposed to SUI or the urinary leakage, and 25% of the females, they are affected by recurrent urinary tract infections, and around 15 to 20% of the females, they face vaginal dryness that leads to painful intercourse or the perineal itching or the burning sensation in the vagina. So what happened with the laxity or the loosening of the vaginal tissue? When there is a flattening of the rugae, there is decrease in the blood supply of the vaginal tissue and there is decrease in the healing capacity of the tissue that leads to increased incidence of the vaginal infections or the discharges. And vagina is also giving support to the bladder and the urethra. Now what is bladder? Bladder is the organ where the urine gets stored, and urethra is the pipe-like structure that is connected to bladder and that carries urine. And that opening of the urethra, which is above the vaginal opening, it is the opening from where the females, they pass the urine. And when there is a laxity or the loosening of the vagina, this support is compromised. And whenever there is a condition like there is an increase in the intra-abdominal pressures like coughing, sneezing, weightlifting, jumping, exercises, there is compromised support to these organs because of the loose vagina and there is leakage of the urine. So this is how vaginal laxity is responsible for the vaginal infections and SUI. Both of these conditions, they are responsible for the recurrent urinary tract infections. Now, how we are giving you the treatment, how we are focusing on the treatment of these conditions. So recently we have introduced our new segment to the gynecology department, that is regenerative gynecology. And we focus on the restoration of the functioning of the organs of the genital area. And here I am talking particularly about the vagina. So how do we restore the function? So basically we focus on the strengthening of your normal healing mechanisms of the body. So treatment is always not about the medicines or the surgery. So we can also do the treatment by enhancing your own body mechanisms. So we have lasers, that is the very advanced and very new technology in the field of regenerative gynecology. And here we use the laser energy. It is a form of heat energy where the old collagen bonds are being broken up and there is a formation of new collagen bonds. There is a formation of new collagen. Collagen gives strength to the vaginal tissue as it is giving everywhere strength in our skin. So this is how the tensile strength of the vagina and the strength of vaginal tissue is improved, and there is a better support to urethra and bladder. There is a better rejuvenation of the tissues, the blood supply of the tissue increases, and there is decrease in the incidence of vaginal infections and SUI. And second, the natural therapy we use is using your own collagen forming growth factors from your own blood. This is called PRP, and we instill in the local area, the vaginal tissue, and there is formation of again the collagen tissue that gives strength to the vaginal tissue. Now the beauty of these procedures is these are painless, these are quick, these are OPD procedures, no anesthesia is required, and you don't need any hospital admission for these procedures. And for any further information or more queries, you can come here, reach to us at Fortis Hospital, Mohali. Thank you.